everybody, and welcome back to NHL Now. Lou Lamouriello is officially the new president of hockey operations for the New York Islanders. That news happening yesterday while EJ and myself were enjoying a nice day off. But we're back now, and we are happy to welcome Lou to the show. Lou, first off, congratulations on the new gig. The obvious first question here, I'm sure you've been asked it a few times over the last couple of days, but what made the Islanders an attractive organization for you?
Well, as you said, I've been asked it a few times over the last couple of days. It was my real conversation and visit with Scott Malkin, who brought me through the vision that he has for the future. And it, you know, sort of sold me. When I say sort of, it did. That's why I'm here. It was a three-prong, really thought process. The practice facility, which I'm sitting in right now, is really state-of-the-art and finished. And the building is, plans are finished. It's only a matter of time when they put a shovel in the ground, and it's going to be state-of-the-art. The technology, the different nuances and amenities that were presented to me just is very exciting. And then, of course, the most important thing to me was having the autonomy to oversee the entire hockey operations and be able to do things whatever way I saw fit to try and, you know, do things a certain way here at the island.
Lou, you've been with the Toronto Maple Leafs the last couple of years. You've been you've obviously watched all these teams. You know the teams in the Eastern Conference. The New York Islanders, a lot of offense last year, not so much defensively. They missed the playoffs. What do they need to do? What do the Islanders need to do from a, like, just a bigger picture? What's the glaring weakness for you as you look from afar about the Islanders?
Well, really, you can look from at something from the outside and start having some sort of opinions, which is the worst thing you can do. I think that what I'm doing right now is coming in no different than what I've done in the past, whether it be Toronto or I went to New Jersey, and Kenny can attest to us. Just take a step back, try and get as much information that I possibly can, speak to people individually, collectively, because I really don't know a lot of people. There are people I do know here, but they're mostly I don't know, and just get to know them and then get their opinions on, you know, how they see certain things. And then I'll form my opinion at that time. But as far as what has to be done, it'd be too premature. You know, there are certainly many things as far as what the priority are. When I say many things, it's no different anywhere. But until you really find out, you really don't know.
Hey, Lou, you've been at this for a long time now, and you talked about the Devils, and we were together for quite some time and had some success. And I was wondering, do you use the same template and formula as you did many years ago when your teams had success, or do you have to adjust as far as how you deal with players nowadays? Because I know what when we had success back in New Jersey and in some of those great years, but nowadays it seems it's changed a little bit, or do you have to have that same template?
That's a great question, Kenny. And, I think one of the things that was great for me personally was when I did go to Toronto in a certainly high visibility market, and, you know, there was a lot that had to be done both on and off the ice. And I feel extremely comfortable that the things that we did in New Jersey as far as the fundamental approach, the accountability, the getting the players to understand that it's all about the logo, the commitment, none of that should and can change to have success. I think all we have to do is look at Las Vegas on what they've done with a group of guys, talented, but, you know, not in the elite category of other teams because they would have protected them, although they are elite players the way they've become. And so I don't want to disrespect anything, but all of that is the same. And I think that's will never change. As far as adjustments, it's the game, the style is the speed is sort of prevalent here more so than ever. The youth is there, but the youth are ready to play a little more than they used to be. The parity is there. You know, the old school we had when you were playing, you know, we had free agency not up until 31, 32, 33. So you could develop them the way you should. This game today, we lose players because we don't give them enough time to develop. But we have to find out about them because free agency comes at an early age. If you come in at 18, you could be a free agent at 25. And, you know, so there are so many things that you adjust that are different. But I think the questions that you ask, what it takes to win, what it takes to compete, the character, all of that will never change. And I think that if you do not have that approach, you won't be able to sustain winning for the period of time with the core players. You might have a flash in a plan year, 1 year where you have success, but you have to have that fundamental group to go forward. And so that's what you try and get, that core. And that core has to be not only quality players, but quality people. And as you know, we were very fortunate through our years to have that.
Lou, I listened to you speak and your passion for the game. I mean, it just, I can hear it in your voice. It really translates. And, you know, you've had a ton of success. You've won Stanley Cups with Dano, our colleague here. You had a lot of success in Toronto. And I was listening to you on the radio earlier and you said, you know, when this opportunity first sort of presented itself, you weren't that interested because you were still dwelling on the playoff losses of the Toronto Maple Leafs, which tells me that, you know, you're still a very competitive, spirited guy. Why do you think after all of the success that you've had and all that you've accomplished, you still have that competitive nature to win and to create a winner in this league?
I wish I could answer that, but when I don't have that or I don't feel that, I'll get to the beach with a cigar and sit there with Kenny and
there you go.
And enjoy everything.
Hey, I'll go too. Like I can smoke a cigar on the beach.
Well, I tell you what. That guy sitting there next to you, Kenny, it's one of the most competitive guys you've ever want to meet.
And sometimes
so he still got it. I've listened to some of his broadcast in the color. I thought he was playing a few times.
and sometimes, Lou, you saw that competitiveness when you had to take me in the office, and that's what I was wondering at times. Do you have to deal with players a little bit different? Are they more sensitive? And as you know, I could be a little sensitive back then, too.
Kenny, if they're too sensitive to doing the right thing or too sensitive to hearing things that they should do, then you shouldn't have them.
Wow. Yeah, hey, that makes a lot
Absolutely.
Of sense. Hey, you know, one guy that, let's face it, Lou, you've already been asked this one. You've been asked a million questions in the last 2 days, but we'll ask it again here. John Tavares is, he's the elephant in the room, so to speak. He can be a free agent if he chooses to be on July 1st. The reports are that you've already had a conversation with John Tavares. What's your feeling about that situation as we move closer now?
Well, you know, let's take it as a group. I mean, here we have the captain. We have an elite player, and we also have an elite human being. So when I make that statement, he's extremely important. And you will do anything and everything to try and, you know, have him continue to play for the Islanders. So that's the best, and that's probably the only comment I can make. I mean, when you've got a combination, and we just talked about this earlier, you know, if your best player being one of your best people, how can you think different?
Well said.
Yeah.
Lou, listen, congratulations again on the new position. We wish you all the best. And it's been a pleasure talking to you. Thanks for doing the show. I know you've probably had a lot of requests over the last couple of days.
Like I said, Jackie, if I didn't get on here, not only would have Kenny, but EJ, but would have driven the car to come.
That's right. Thanks, Lou.
Well, we'll keep that in mind through the season next year when we want you on the show.
All right. It's a pleasure. Thank you.